wonderful past and present. And can I start off by talking about music tonight and thank our wonderful musical director and the biggest orchestra on Broadway. This is a rather special night for me for a number of reasons, and it gives me a chance to say thank you to somebody who, frankly, for the Phantom of the Opera, wouldn't have happened without her. She was my muse, she was the person who was beside me when the whole show was being created. And it is a great, great joy for me tonight to be able to introduce you to my angel of music, Sarah Brightman.
Your manager commends you, sir.
I thought something was dodgy when I saw that statement.
Listen, I wanted to come on first.
Oh, to camera. Just several things I've got several things for people. First, I never travel business class. Come all this way.
And you paid enough money out of this to pay the extra. I get
it. Well, you don't.
No, but I buy my own plane.
You buy your own jet, I know.
Where is the piano?
I promise.
Where is
the piano camera?
I promise.
You promised me a piano,
so
I could do this.
You did the piano in London, and I haven't got over it yet. I was really, really upset. Before that, I want to say to you, what, 30 years?
Yeah, okay.
Who'd have thought it? But I tell you, it was a bloody good idea,
wasn't it?
God, Sarah turned down Christine in that other verse. Michael Crawford would be rather good in it.
Yes.
It's not the same Sarah for.
We have a very, very, very great deal. Yes. But one of the things that I have to say, Cameron, and I hope you don't mind my saying this, is that whilst I think the show is fine, and it's pretty technically annoying tonight, quite frankly, you know, we need to kind of get it going a little bit more. It doesn't really have a contemporary rock feel.
I remember once upon a time when we had really good director, apart from Hal Prince, before Hal Prince came, and even Bridget Moore, we had a wonderful video.
We did indeed.
Wonderful guest with Servants in it.
Directed by Ken Russell.
However,
tonight, I have decided to liven up the proceedings. Yes. And since you can't provide a piano for me, I have provided a proper rock group tonight. So here, to sing and or to play for the first time live on stage, I brought to you tonight the Kinks from School of Rock.
Thank you.
I always have
yes, absolutely.
Camera, I tend to say that.
Yes, I know.
So could you leave the stage?
Not yet.
We have a lot of people we have to thank, and we have to start with some people who sadly are not here tonight.
And of course, the person who created the magic world of Phantom of the Opera, and who was with us actually, even as the show was being written and when it was staged down in Symington.
I mean, one of the most extraordinary things that can ever happen for any composer or any writer of a musical is when the design of the show completely marries what one hoped the music in every way was extraordinarily matched by the incredible Maria Bjorn's score.
I know she's up there, still sending her notes on everything. She is truly, truly amazing.
She was a fantastic, fantastic thought, and an amazing, amazing designer in every single way. And she was indeed with us from the very, very word-go. She even did the design when we tried it out at my little festival at Sydney.
Yes, and she crashed the chandelier on someone's head.
Yes, she did. Actually, the editor of some newspaper, which was unfortunate.
But also, her wonderful design is, of course, lit by the wonderful Andy Bridge.
One of the saddest things tonight is that we don't have the great, fabulous Gillian Lynn with us. Gillian is unfortunately had a touch of pneumonia back in Britain, but we know she's recovering, and we send our very, very best wishes to the dearest Gillian.
There is no one like Gillian anywhere in the world. I've known her nearly all of my life, and her attention to detail and her imagination knows no bounds, and so we owe her an enormous debt.
And I must say thanks to Richard Stilgoe and Charlie
yes.
Hart,
our
fabulous leaders.
We've been very lucky to have such a brilliant team.
We have, and it's one of those extraordinary things when I always think we are only just little cogs in that wheel of what makes a great musical. And very rarely does it happen that every single element comes together, which I believe it did in this one.
Absolutely. And 30 years, not only here but around America, the amount of brilliant musicians and wonderful artists that have actually been involved.
Yes.
And all the people who don't see that make the scenery and call our production teams and creative teams, they've been amazing.
I mean, it's an incredible achievement. But I was just thinking tonight, I mean, it's a black box in Mongolia, but it's full.
It's expensive.
But it's a real, really extraordinary thing that the stage crew do every night. So.
We should also thank the other five of the composer, which is the audience, who had loved the show since the very, very first thing. Thank you for allowing him to even go business class. And me first.
Premium economy, I think it was.
Would you really accept that?
Thank you, Howard. Now, we now... There is one.
The only... The master. The master producer, the master director. One of the greatest men of show business and musical theatre. The one and only, Al Bruce.
Over 1,000 members of Actors Equity have have been employed by this show. In addition, employment has extended to 6,500 people, including vendors, artisans, and front of house and all the rest. But it's actually, it's affected other businesses. Restaurants, coffee shops, and God help us, parking lot owners. Phantom has played 174 cities in 37 countries. To an audience of over 140 million people. My friends here have mentioned the amazing collection of collaborators we had through the rehearsal period, through the previews, and for the length, the very extended length of this show. One of the most important, was our lighting designer, and happily, he is here tonight. Ladies and gentlemen, Andy Britt.
Fabulous Hal Prince, who is 90 years of age next week!